Africa Day. The first one happened here in Dundalk. We are so delighted to see this day. The preparation has been on for a couple of weeks now, and it's nice to get this out today. As I said, my name is Flora Kobe, and I'm involved with Culture Connect. Culture Connect and the organizing team and the Louth County Council have put this event together today. And this is the first of its kind in Louth. We need to put our hands together, first of its kind. It's not easy for this to happen, but we're so delighted that finally it has happened. And like you know, Africa Day is a national event. Most other counties may have had theirs last week, and some are yet to have. And for Louth, we have two of this kind, one in Dundalk and the other one in Drogheda. So the other one is happening this Sunday at 2 p.m. at St. Peter's Church in Drogheda. So for the Africa Day as a national event, as we all know, it's been sponsored by the Department of Foreign Affairs through the Irish Aid. And then it's just to appreciate the relationship between Africa and Ireland. And back in those days, everyone usually go to Dublin in St. Finnan's Park to celebrate Africa Day. But a few years ago, the government has decided that each county will celebrate their own Africa Day. And since then, we have been looking forward to having it in Louth, but finally it has happened this year, and we are so delighted. And putting it together has not been an easy task, but we have a powerful organizing team and a couple of individuals and African groups in Louth have been able to put this together. So thank you, all of you that have been able to do this. I have Moya here from the council. The council is very much in support of this program, and I will have Moya here to introduce and welcome some of the councillors that are here, and we will take it up from there. After that, Timmy is going to tell us more about the Africa Day. Thank you.
Thank you, Flora. I contacted Flora back in February saying, I believe you've been tormenting us for 2 years to help you organise the World Africa Day, so it was an absolute privilege to make the application on their behalf. And it's great to be here today for the first ever events in Louth. I'm delighted to be joined by some of my colleagues here, Councillor Maeve Yore, Councillor John Riley, and Councillor Marianne Butler, so it's great to see them. The council are delighted to be here to support it, and hopefully this will be the first of many events in the future for us. So thank you all for coming, and hopefully here's to a great afternoon's entertainment.
So along with this group, we have the Somalian group. Their table is down there. And we have the African Centre. It's a new group. They are down there with their artwork, powerful artwork. And then we have the West African foods down that way, the ladies there. And then we have the Culture Connect table there, and then the DJ. So you're all welcome. And in this program today, we will have a couple of speakers on this event. And one of them is going to speak on Africa, the relationship between Africa and Ireland. And that will be Dr. Coletta. And then the next speaker also, Dr. Medua Konkor, is going to speak on the Africans in Ireland. And we might have a student speaking on her experience about Africa. If she's here and she's ready, she's going to do that. And we have a couple of great music artists here today who are going to entertain us with the great talents that they have. And then we will have our food. The program is on the table, but before we go ahead, I want to call on Evelyn, whom I met a few weeks ago, and she's a great woman.
And from that connection and conversation, we're here too. teddy bear. But this green little teddy bear does have a lot of magic, and we can all make it magical. So anyway, and Why Jean Wada is the story of the mermaid in Donegal. You could think of it as the metaphor of the mother, the great mother, the earth. She's calling out to all of her children. So I'll give you the first stanza, and then I'm going to get you on your feet, coming in, everyone in a bit more of a circle.
Another Nigerian in the house. This is not something special. Okay. Surprising. How many Nigerians do you have in the house? Raise my hand. Nigerians in the house. Ghanaians in the house. Can I see your hands up? Ghanaians in the house. Any Ghanaians in the house? Can I see your hands up? Any Somalians in the house? Let me see your hands up. Okay. Ethiopians in the house? No? Okay. Anyone else have permission? Uganda? Congo? Oh, Uganda. Oh, Uganda? I can't say the same. Uganda. Okay, we'll put you in Uganda today. Togo, Togo. Oh, fantastic. Yeah, this way. This way. Okay, yeah. So, without spending more time, I'm going to let Viv. Viv is from Nigeria. What part of Nigeria?
I'm from Delta State.
Which is where exactly? What's up?
It's the south.
In the middle to the south. Okay.
Oh,
okay. So, can we have someone who will actually go out with a message? Okay. Okay. So, anyway, you're going to put two songs for us, right? Is that correct? All right. So, the cable for the mic isn't so long, so you're going to be around here. Okay. Don't go down there. Okay. All right. So, when you're ready.
Hi, everyone. My name is Vivian, and I have two songs for us. And the two songs basically reflect, you know, the way of life of Africans. I wouldn't say we are religious, but you know, everything is God first. Good, bad, ugly, God first. So the first song is one of my personal songs, and it's called Praise You Every Day. It means, the message in the song is whatever the issue, whatever the challenges in life, you know, we will praise God. I will praise God. We will praise God every day. And the second one, I call it a warning song. It's from Chris Essien, one of you know the Nigerian musician. And the song is Shewure.